5, 4, 3, 2, 1, kill! Please all join me in singing for this lovely thing. For he that's all in good sense. For he that's all in good sense. For he that's all in good sense. And so say all of us. And so say all of us. For he's a jolly good fellow. He's a jolly good fellow. For he's a jolly good fellow. And so say all of us. Please join me, ladies. We have each other. It's wonderful. Congratulations. But I couldn't refuse when I had been asked to propose a toast for just Governor this evening. Because the request came from a very, very good friend, the person of the RA, our host with the most, and his dear wife. And the person who I'm supposed to propose a toast of is somebody who I just could not refuse.
Coming Yeyelisa of Lagos, Dupe Oguntade. He's going now out as His Excellency Justice Chief Oguntade. But I'll hide from you what he probably will return as. Justice Oguntade was born on the 10th of March 1940. He started school at St. Michael's School, Efe, in 1946. He proceeded to Ijebuode Grammar School in 1953, where I first met him 64 years ago. He left in 1958 and worked as a court clerk between 1958 and 1961, during which he was bitten by the legal bug. He proceeded to the UK and studied law at the University of London, obtained an LLB from the Holborn College of Law. He was at the mandatory law school on his return between 1965 and 1966. He entered private legal practice 1966 to 1980. In 1980, he was elevated to the bench and went through the following positions: Judge, High Court of Lagos.
Judge, Court of Appeal, Ibadan, 93 to 95. Presiding Judge, Court of Appeal, Judge, 95 to 98. Presiding Judge, Lagos, 1999 to 2002. Presiding Judge, Abuja, 2003 to 2004. Justice of the Supreme Court, 2004 to 2010. There were several papers which I will not bother you with, but they are quite impressive. But if you will allow me, I'll summarize by saying that some of them are judiciary, some have to do with corruption, some have to do with public governance, some have to do with electioneering process in Africa,
and the law, national development, and so on.
His Excellency Justice Oguntade did not confine himself to involvement in the legalities of life. He was also a social figure as well as a religious person. He belonged to the Rotary Club, he belonged to the Yoruba Tennis Club, Motorboat Club, the Island Club, the Koi Club. And on the religious front, he was Chancellor of the Anglican Commission, Church of Nigeria, 1992, and Chancellor of the Anglican Commission, Diocese of Lagos, 1999 to date. He was honored by his country with the honored Commander of the Nigeria in 2005, Commander of the Federal Republic in 2010. To cap his legal achievements, he was awarded Fellow of the Chartered Institute of Arbitrators, UK, Nigeria Chapter, Fellow Nigerian Institute of Advanced Legal Studies, Member of the World Jurist Association. To cap it all, now he has been appointed as Nigeria's High Commissioner to the United Kingdom, a country which used to be our colonial master. That's a very, very sensitive position, and I want to assure Nigeria they have a very qualified man to fill that position.
To be balloting, claiming Justice Oguntade as an Ijebu man, I feel obliged to say that we hold him in Lagos. And I want to acknowledge you, sir, for the very wonderful and great things you have done for the people of Lagos. You deserve a very loud round of applause. I cannot begin to list the many, many great things you've done for us. But I want to say one particular one.
Say to the Court of St. James's, all we can indeed hope and pray is that the good Lord who has stood with you when you were in all the courts in Nigeria will also go with you to the Court of St. James's, and that you will adorn that court with the same grace, elegance and distinction as you adorned the Nigerian courts. Thank you very much. God bless you all.
His knowledge, his honesty, his ability to care for others, his commitment to his people, his commitment to Nigeria, and his commitment to the judiciary. Today, he's been appointed to represent our great country at the Court of St. James's. For all I know about diplomacy, the Court of St. James's is the highest in that cadre. Thereafter, you talk about France, because the language of diplomacy is French, like you all do know. Then, of course, Washington, D.C., China, Germany, in that order. And now, we're here to say thank you to the President, the Commander-in-Chief of the Air Forces of Nigeria, for finding you worthy to represent our country in the United Kingdom. You will find that it's not the same as sitting in judgment over litigants or presentations. It is all about simple common sense that God is endowed you with. And I am sure, I am absolutely certain that you will deliver on your calling. Nigerians are bound in the UK, as indeed those in Europe would wish to come to the UK to find solace with you. Because, like I said, the UK is topmost in our diplomatic arcade. But having served all over Nigeria, I know in my other part of the country, which is Igbo land, you are revered. Because the Igbo, the people gave you one of the highest chieftaincy titles. And I want to thank you. I say, so Gaga, Gaga, Nike, Tine, Koronti, Le, Koronti, Wa, Awal, Loshi, Shefu, Maje, Kenny, for the Kota, eh? One fender, any high commission to match a schedule on you. More diplomat one, one man that I want to say, my judge, although the judge, unless I like me, that when I take you. So finally, I pray the Almighty God that the Queen, which is head of the Commonwealth and head of the UK, would find you worthy, you and your darling wife, Nubem, who stood by you time and again, and stood by you now, will still stand by you when you go there. And Nubem, Come on, say that. Come on, come on, Jack. We know how much. Allah, my God, we shall not be ashamed.